Welcome everyone to my channel that is Fast and Easy Maths, which is dedicated to give you tips and tricks related to mathematics. So students, a lot of y'all keep asking for how to convert fractions to decimals. Okay, so like if it is divided by 10 or 1000 or 100, I've already made a video on that. If you don't know, then I'll put a link on top or somewhere in the description as well. Okay, but when it comes to numbers, like, you know, when it comes to like the numerator being very high or the denominator being very low, or in this case the denominator is very high, then in that case how do you divide it? Okay, when it is not completely divisible, then in that case I've taken three options and there will be one more. Okay, then what you should do in this case, I'm going to show you over here. Very basic, a lot of y'all don't, if you don't know, the numerator goes here and the denominator comes here. Now please understand, if your numerator or if your number over here is smaller than the number given over here, then you have the liberty of taking a decimal point over here and putting a zero besides this number. So now we know 8 threes are gets you 24. You're left with 6. Now you can again put a zero over here because 6 is less than 8. But you are putting a zero over here, you do not have to put a zero or a decimal point. Decimal point already taken, okay? So when you have taken one decimal point, you always have the liberty to use one zero. Only one zero, please understand. If you use more than that, then you will have to add a zero over here. Okay, please, I'm going to repeat this one more time. If you have taken a decimal point, then you can add only one zero to the number, okay? And still, if that number would have been smaller, if this was 80 and if you add 0 over here, then this is still smaller than 30, still smaller than 80. Then in that case, what you should do, you add one more 0. So your answer would have started from 0.0. Understood? Decimal point gives you the liberty of adding just one 0, okay? So now over here, this is 7s, we get 56. We're left with 4. We can take a 0. I do not have to add any 0 in my quotient because the decimal point allows me to add one 0 at least. And this is 5 and this is 40. So my answer over here is 0.375. Okay. Now next. Now this is what we have. 3 over here. We have 4. 3 ones are gets me 3. I'm left with 1. So I can put a decimal and this is 0. And this is 3. So gets me 9, 1. So again 3, 0, 9, again 10, minus 9, so again 3, sorry 1. So this, if you see, it's going on. So I can say my answer is 1.33, where 33 is recurring. Okay, now like I had said, there is a scenario where we might have to add a 0 even after using the decimal point. Okay, this is that question where you can do that. If you have understood whatever I've told you till now, then you can take a pause at this moment and try to solve this one. Okay, and see whether you're getting it right or wrong. Students, please go ahead and hit the like button because that gives me tremendous amount of encouragement in doing these kind of videos. Also, don't forget, at the end of the video, I'm going to put up a DIY question and you're going to use the method shown in this video to solve that question, and let me know your answers in the comment section. I will definitely read those and let you know whether you are right or wrong. Okay, now over here we have 1003 and 400. Now here itself, the numerator right now is bigger. Okay, so we know 4 into 2 gets you 8, so 400 into 2 will get you 800. 4 into 3 gets you 12. So 400 into 3 will get you 1200. 1200 is very big. Please understand, in division you need to have numbers which are exact or smaller than the given number inside. Okay, so we can have 4 twos gets you 800. So we are left with 203. Okay, now we take a point. Why point? Because 203 is less than 400. The moment I take a point, I am getting the liberty of adding one zero over here. Okay, so now the number coming over here is 2030. So now 4 into 3 was 1200. 4 into 6 will be 400 into 6 will, 400 into 4 will get you 1600. 400 into 5 will get you 2000. So that is very close to 2030. So I'm going to subtract 2030. I'm going to subtract 2000 from 2030. So we're getting 30 now. Now this is where the trick begins. Since we have already taken a point, not the trick, actually this is a concept which you need to know. Okay, so this is now becoming 300. Why I took 10? Because there was a decimal point, so I can take 10. Okay, now the problem over here, what I'm facing is 300 is still smaller than 400. So I have to take one more zero. Now, like I said, we have the liberty of taking only 10 when we have taken a decimal point. So if I have taken an additional zero, I'm going to add that zero in my quotient as well. Okay, so now 400 into 7 gets you 2800. Subtracted, you get 200. Now after this, you might be wondering, should I add a zero? And if I'm adding a zero, should I put it in the quotient or not? No, you do not have to put it in the quotient because you still have the liberty of taking 10 because of the decimal point given over here. Okay, so now 400 into 5 gets you 2000. So here your answer is 2.5075. Okay, now I know this was a bit lengthy. While explaining, I took a lot of time. So very quickly, let's see what happens when we have to divide 501 by 200. So here we have 501, we have 200. Okay, so 200 into 2 gets you 400. We are left with 101. So we're taking a point. So we have 2.5 by 5, because 200 into 5 gets you 1000. I'm left with 10. Now again a problem, because this is getting me 100. Now 100 is smaller than 200, right? Why 100? Because we were left with 10 and then we added a 0 which we had the liberty of. Okay, so now we can add one more 0, but when you do that you have to add a 0 over here also. So now 200 into 5 gets you 1000. So your answer now changes to 2.505. Okay, I hope you all got the concept which I was trying to teach you. Lot of you all make these mistakes, and if you don't make these mistakes, it's very good. And if you had any confusion, I'm hoping that all of this confusion got solved with this particular video. If you still have any confusion, then please let me know. So I will try to make one more video on similar kind of a numbers. Okay, so now time for your DIY. You have to tell me what will be the decimal form of 101 when divided by 80. Okay, do let me know your answers in the comment section. That's it for now. I will see you in the next video.